Hey everyone, my name is Alvin Chong, and I'm a mechanical engineer on the design for service and repair team here at Microsoft. Today, I'll be guiding you through the full teardown and reassembly of the Microsoft Windows 365 Link. We'll cover every major component step by step so you can confidently perform repairs or replacements as needed. The design team has made many improvements and features targeted specifically for repair, which I will highlight throughout the video. In fact, you will only need an ESD-safe PH1 Phillips head screwdriver to remove any screws on this device. Please note that I'm only going to demonstrate how to tear down, reassemble, and access the replaceable components at a high level. So before we begin, please review the detailed service guide and follow the safety guidelines available on the Microsoft Learn portal. Additionally, always work on a soft, ESD-safe surface, wear an anti-static wrist strap, and have all recommended tools ready. Today, you'll be needing plastic ESD-safe tweezers, an ESD-safe PH1 Phillips head screwdriver, metal ESD-safe tweezers, and a plastic ESD-safe spudger. Also, remove any jewelry like watches or rings and tie back any long hair. With that, we're gonna get started. We'll get started with the disassembly of your device by removing the plate screw covers. Please turn over your Windows 365 Link and put it on a level and flat, ESD-safe, soft, non-marring material. We're going to use our plastic ESD-safe tweezers to remove the four plate screw covers. Be sure to proceed slowly and gently to preserve the reusability of the Link plate screw covers and the adhesive. If there is any wrinkling of the adhesive or of the plate screw covers, you must replace them with the new screw cover replacement kit and cannot reuse them again after removal. Now with the plate screw covers off, we'll work to remove the bottom plate and the motherboard using a PH1 Phillips head screwdriver to unscrew the four exposed screws. Please note that you will not be able to fully remove these screws, and please press firmly to avoid potentially stripping the head of the screw. Now with your hands, carefully wiggle the bottom cover to separate it from the rest of the device. Then place the bottom cover on an ESD-safe, soft, non-marring material. At this point, the battery itself is exposed, so make sure that at any point from here on out, please make sure you're not touching or pressing on the battery in any way. Now to continue disassembling and removing your motherboard, we're going to use a PH1 Phillips head screwdriver again to unscrew and remove the one screw holding down the Wi-Fi card. We also recommend that you count screws and place them away from your device as you go along. This is to ensure that there will be no loose screws remaining inside your device when it comes time to reassemble it. With your hands, carefully wiggle the Wi-Fi card to separate it from the connector on the motherboard and route the Wi-Fi card away from your device. Now we will work to remove the shield covering the remaining screws on the motherboard. With a metal ESD-safe tweezer, carefully pry up the shield starting from the bottom left corner in this orientation and gently continue prying around the perimeter of the shield to completely remove it. Now we will use a PH1 Phillips head screwdriver to unscrew and remove the four newly exposed screws. We have made efforts to implement wayfinding artwork on this product to help you locate the relevant screws, but still be sure to count and keep track of your screws before moving forward. With a plastic ESD-safe spudger, we're going to now gently disconnect the power button cable and route it away from the motherboard. Now, although the coin cell battery with your Link is reusable after repair, and the Link motherboard replacement kit comes with a pre-assembled replacement coin cell battery, I will now demonstrate how to remove the battery if you need to. The details for independently purchasing an off-the-shelf battery and adhesive for repairing the battery separately can be found in the service guide on the Microsoft Learn portal if needed. We're going to turn the device around and use our plastic ESD-safe spudger. We will now gently wiggle and disconnect the battery cable from the connector on the motherboard. And now with the same tool, slowly and carefully separate the battery from your motherboard. If there's any large chunks of adhesive remaining on the motherboard, please use your plastic ESD-safe spudger to gently remove it. Afterwards, use isopropyl alcohol and cleaning swabs. I will not be demonstrating this or any future cleaning steps for time's sake and for the purpose of this high-level overview. Now, before removing your motherboard from the enclosure, please make sure that the Wi-Fi card and the power button cable are not obstructing the path. With a plastic ESD-safe spudger in your hands, Gently remove the motherboard from the enclosure and set it aside on an ESD-safe, soft, non-marring material for reuse later. Now with your motherboard removed from your device, use isopropyl alcohol and cleaning swabs to clean off the CPU thermal pad from your motherboard and your enclosure heat spreader. Now to begin removing the enclosure heat spreader, we will use a PH1 Phillips head screwdriver to unscrew and remove the two screws holding down the power button subassembly. With those two screws now removed, let's now gently remove the power button subassembly from the enclosure heat spreader and set it aside on an ESD-safe, soft, non-marring material for reuse later. Now to remove your enclosure heat spreader, we will use a PH1 Phillips head screwdriver again to unscrew and remove the four remaining screws. With your hands, gently remove the enclosure heat spreader, otherwise known as the thermal shield, from the top enclosure and set it aside on an ESD-safe, soft, non-marring material for reuse later. And with that, we are done with the disassembly portion of your new Microsoft Windows 365 Link. I just want to take a second here to recognize the amazing work the cross-functional team has done to make this device as repairable as it is now. Throughout the disassembly so far, you may have noticed that all of the components were all easily removable without the use of any hidden glues. That will also remain true as we continue on to reassemble the entire device. Now we will reassemble your Windows 365 Link with a brand new top enclosure. We will begin by gently inserting your reusable thermal shield into the new top enclosure. Once again, we will use a PH1 Phillips head screwdriver to install the four new screws that came in your replacement kit to secure the reusable thermal shield to the new top enclosure. After the screw is snug, only tighten the screws an additional 1/8 turn, about 45 degrees, to avoid tripping the threads. Now, gently insert your reusable power button subassembly into the thermal shield. Now we'll use a PH1 Phillips head screwdriver again to install the two new screws that secure the power button subassembly to the thermal shield. Please do not reuse screws and only use the new screws that came in your official replacement kit. Once again, we have made efforts to implement wayfinding artwork on this product to help you locate the relevant screws, but still be sure to count and keep track of your screws before moving forward. Now moving on to reassembling your motherboard. If you are reusing your old, undamaged motherboard, please use isopropyl alcohol and cleaning swabs to clean any leftover adhesive or thermal interface material and install a new CPU thermal pad that came in your replacement kit. Now to place your motherboard into the enclosure, start with the side that has more ports and make sure that the Wi-Fi card and power button cable are out of the way to gently insert your motherboard into the enclosure. Make sure that it is sitting flush and there are no cables or connectors obstructing it. Now we will gently reconnect the Wi-Fi card to the connector on the motherboard and use a PH1 Phillips head screwdriver to install a new screw. After the screw is snug, only tighten the screw an additional 1/8 turn, about 45 degrees, to avoid tripping the threads. Now with a plastic ESD-safe spudger, carefully align and gently connect the power button cable to the connector on the motherboard. With a PH1 Phillips head screwdriver, install the four new screws to hold the motherboard to the top enclosure. Once again, after the screws are snug, only tighten the screws an additional 1/8 turn, about 45 degrees, to avoid stripping the threads. With those four screws installed, now we will align a new Link motherboard shield and firmly press in those tabs around the perimeter with a plastic ESD-safe spudger. Be sure to press down firmly to ensure it is fully secured. If you are installing a new Link motherboard, make sure to install the three new foam pieces that came as collateral material above the USB-A port connectors. Before we put on the bottom cover and close up your device, if you would like to replace your battery, as I'm demonstrating now, ensure that all screws are accounted for and there are no floating screws near where the battery will be installed. Also, inspect for any foreign debris that might be present. Only after using cleaning alcohol to clean the old adhesive on the motherboard and letting it dry, place the off-the-shelf battery with pre-assembled adhesive on it in its respective location and lightly press down for 30 seconds to activate the adhesive. Now we will use our hands to gently connect the battery cable to your motherboard. If the off-the-shelf battery cable is longer than the original battery's cable, be sure to tuck the cable underneath the motherboard so it is not in the way when we reassemble the bottom cover. Now before installing your reusable bottom plate, ensure the battery cable is routed below the motherboard. Then, orient the bottom plate to the device with the arrow pointing towards the power button and the battery. And then place your bottom cover gently over the device. With a PH1 Phillips head screwdriver, tighten the four screws that hold the bottom plate to the device. And once again, after the screws are snug, only tighten the screws an additional eighth turn, about 45 degrees, to avoid stripping the threads. And now that we've reassembled your motherboard, regardless if you're reusing the old one or installing a new one, please follow the Windows 365 link functional testing process detailed on the Microsoft Learn portal. Now to finish repair of your device, we can now either reuse the old four-plate screw covers if the adhesive underneath them was not crinkled, or choose to install four new plate screw covers provided only in a separate replacement kit order. If you choose to install new plate screw covers ordered from a separate replacement kit, be sure to use isopropyl alcohol and cleaning swabs to clean any old adhesive from the previous plate screw covers. Only after the alcohol dries, insert the four new link plate screw covers into the respective locations and firmly press them in for 30 seconds each. Good job! With this, we have completed both the disassembly and reassembly of all spare parts that are available for repair on the new Microsoft Windows 365 Link. We wanted to make that repair process as easy as possible so you could get back to enjoying your device as soon as possible. Big thanks to the great work done by the various teams to make this a reality. With that, thank you for your time, and I really hope you found this video useful. If you have any questions, please find more detailed instructions on the service guide, available on the Microsoft Learn portal.